Tom Barnes, Chicago scene. You see that script right there? That soon will be a play, and that play is the brainchild of Maurice Proffitt. How are you, sir?
I'm doing that great. How about you?
I'm doing wonderful. Thank you for inviting me in. Here we are on a weekend, living the dream with, in regards to the arts, because you're doing rehearsals for your big performance you have coming up this week, the 26th.
February 26th.
Yes. So what we saw there was Lorraine, and that's part of the theater company that you kind of work with. Why don't you explain that whole process real quick and how we get to the play itself?
Sure, absolutely. So the theater production company is an entertainment company called B-Side Studios, which I founded and I run. And B-Side Studios is proudly presenting Lorraine, which was written by Carlos J. Gomez. Mm-hmm. He's the writer of the script, and I'm producing and directing the script. And basically what this story is about is two young people who are on the way to getting married, and unbeknownst to them, their parents, both sets of their parents, are following them as they're going down south to get married. And both sets of their parents do not approve of this marriage at all, so there is some conflict that comes about when it comes to, like, you know, how they're viewing this marriage and how they also view the world as well too. Now the thing is though is that this takes place at the Lorraine Motel, and we all know the Lorraine Motel is known for the unfortunate death of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., which took place in 1968, and they don't know that Dr. King is at that same motel that they are in as well. And so when in the story, King is assassinated, and when that death happens, that kind of turns a lot of things around in terms of, like, the perceptions that are taking place with the parents when it comes to, like, some of their viewpoints, and also when it comes to, like, you know, like, them really realizing that their kids, you know, pretty much are on the right track in terms of, like, you know, their way of thinking in terms of, like, you know, being much more open and honest, you know, when it comes to, like, our society and whatnot. So you do see a lot when it comes to just how things turn around. You know, it turns around, you know, we they're in the position where there's conflict, but then when this tragic moment takes place, then they find themselves in a position where, you know, accepting reality and also accepting that there's much more to a narrow-minded mentality is what's fruitful for them.
And so with that in mind, with it coming up here on the 26th, tell me about the theater company itself, just because this is the 23rd year that you've done something like this, minus the, you did something virtual last year for the pandemic. But talk about the theater company, the Chicago roots, and what you really want people to get out of this, you know, being Black History Month, but besides just the 1 month, the whole year of what you guys do and how you give back to the community.
Definitely, absolutely. So the theater company was originally called Powerhouse Productions. And that was founded in 1999. And that's when we had our very first Black History production taking place in Schaumburg. And it was founded because there was a lack of any type of acknowledgement when it comes to Black history in the village of Schaumburg. And my mother was the one who started everything off, because she saw that there was a void, and she met with Schaumburg, the Schaumburg mayor and the officials and everything, and wanted to bring a Black History production to the village. And the village was totally behind it. And so they gave her the resources and everything like that, and to launch the first production. And from there, she started the theater company. Now, I've always been a part of the theater company in some way, shape, or form. I was always a stagehand. I was always, like, you know, working
with
marketing.
Grew up with it.
Yeah, exactly. You,
we were talking, this is, like, you're 40 years into this.
Yeah.
Just in theater in general, you've been directing for a better part of 10,
yes,
is that right?
Exactly. And so I've been directing for a little over 10 years, and I started my own production company called B-Side Studios. Mm-hmm. And B-Side Studios is not only just theater, but it's also film, it's television, it's web series, it's reality shows, and even the anime as well too. So it's a whole plethora of outlets for entertainment. And what it focuses on bringing non-traditional artists into onto a platform, so this way they can display their talents. And the theater portion of B-Side Studios really does exhibit that. You know, we have a wide variety of different type of actors from all age groups who come out and be a part of these production of these shows.
And this show is at the same spot every year, correct?
Yes. Yeah, it's the same spot. It's the Al Larson Prairie Center for the Arts in Schaumburg, Illinois. Mm-hmm. And you know, we make a very big spectacle of that night. It's an experience. It's not just a play, but it's also coming out to see vendors of, like, you know, of local businesses when coming out and selling their products, having a red carpet, the step and repeat, having media on hand to interview people on live Instagram or live Facebook or whatever may have you. We have giveaways as well too. This show is being sponsored by NeoGrid, and it's a supply chain management technology company that's based in Brazil, mm-hmm. and so they're a part of this as well too. So it's going to be a really fun time. It's great for all ages, for everyone in the family as well, because we always make sure that we make family oriented pieces where it's entertaining enough where it satisfies everybody in the family, but also at the same time there's substance. So this way the families can walk away with some actual substance and actually taking away something from the show this way they can apply it to their lives.
Right, and that's why I'm here today, just because I wanted to get here ahead of the actual event so people can know about it, and we put this up and people will see this. And earlier we saw a little behind the scenes moment with one of your, or two of your actors.
Yeah.
What was that scene for people who are listening a little bit, maybe on the B-roll as we're showing it right now? What was that little scene there?
Yeah, so that scene right there, what that was the daughter, her name was Lisa. Her parents are you know, pretty much following her and her boyfriend Hayden to this motel. And Lisa doesn't know that the parents are on their tail looking for them. Mm-hmm. But the parents, they find that Lisa's staying at the Lorraine Motel. So they kind of like, you know, come into the motel, like, where is she? Where is she? And, you know, they're expressing like it's more so the father, Thomas, who's
he was a little fired up.
He's expressing his his displeasure of the union between the two. Mm-hmm. Whereas the mother, Maggie, she is like very much for the voice of reason.
Yes,
and making
grounded.
Him understand, like, you know, listen, like, you know, you're looking at things irrationally. It's about love and this and the other. And he's like, that's my daughter. So, you know, so you have like that night and day difference when it comes to, like, you know, this older married couple, you know, pretty much talking about their daughter and about her life. And so you're seeing a lot of that in the show. And a lot of us can relate to that because, you know, there are many parents going to be watching this who have probably been in that position before, or maybe they might be in that position. Mm-hmm. And then there's young people who will be watching this as well too, where they can say, yeah, like, my parents are just like that. So everybody can kind of see themselves on that stage.
For sure.
Yeah.
For people who want information about the play itself or just to get involved with your theater company and be a part of this, how can they go about doing that?
Absolutely. So I highly recommend visiting bsidestudios.net. That's bsidestudios.net. And you can follow us on social media as well too. Look for B-Side Studios on Facebook and follow B-Side Studios on Instagram as well at bside.studios. And we look at everybody. We give everyone an opportunity and a chance. So if you have even like the little sliver of an artistic side of you that's inside of you, and you might be interested, come talk to us, and we'll find a place for you, because, you know, we're all about opportunity for everybody across the board.
Mr. Maurice Proffitt, thank you very much. I appreciate you taking time, especially on your weekend, to allow me to come in and crash the rehearsals. I appreciate it very much, and good luck to you on the 26th.
Thank you so much, Tom. The pleasure is all mine. You're welcome anytime. Thank you very much for this.
Absolutely. That's the Chicago scene today. We're in Jefferson Park, but the theater that people are going to is in
Schaumburg, Illinois, mm-hmm. the Al Larson Prairie Center for the Arts.
You heard him. That is TBARNAS. TBARNAS at WGNTV.com. It's only been my email for like 15 years. that's TBARNAS at WGNTV.com. If you have a suggestion for the Chicago scene, thank you very much. Mr. Proffitt, thank you.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.